years, the National Sea Grant College Program has been promoting economic development in coastal businesses.
It has been fostering stewardship of coastal habitat, and it has been aiding the responsible use of America's ocean, coastal, and Great Lakes resources.
This highly effective program was the brainchild of oceanographer Athelstan Spillhouse. His idea caught hold, and Senator Claiborne Pell of Rhode Island championed it in Washington. In 1966, the National Sea Grant College Program Act was signed into law.
Since then, Sea Grant has become a national network of 33 programs involving more than 3,000 university scientists, engineers, law centers, educators, outreach experts, and students. Among Sea Grant's many accomplishments during the last 50 years, several stand out.
From its beginning, Sea Grant has nurtured the development of a domestic aquaculture industry to help ensure that we have a sustainable supply of seafood. Over the last 4 years alone, Sea Grant provided $26 million for aquaculture research and technology, creating a $200 million economic impact and more than 8,000 jobs.
Every year, Sea Grant supplies state and federal fisheries managers with science-based information, vital to maintaining our most valuable wild commercial fisheries: lobsters in the Northeast, salmon in Alaska and the Pacific Northwest, shrimp in the Southeast and Gulf of Mexico, and oysters and clams on all of our ocean coasts.
Sea Grant has helped thousands of commercial fishermen increase their harvest and adopt new technology that reduces the incidental catch of turtles and birds.
In the 1990s, the program spearheaded the development of a national seafood safety training program. Since 2001, over 90% of U.S. seafood processing firms and more than 26,000 individuals have received this training, preventing an estimated 60,000 seafood-related illnesses each year.
In 1989, Sea Grant helped communities in Prince William Sound as oil spilled from the grounded Exxon Valdez. In 2010, Sea Grant staff and scientists all along the Gulf of Mexico responded rapidly to the Deepwater Horizon tragedy by providing science-based advice on dealing with the disaster to community leaders and local residents.
On Pacific Islands and across the nation, Sea Grant programs are responding to the increasing frequency and severity of coastal storms. With a handbook adapted from Hawaii Sea Grant, they are helping thousands of coastal residents fortify their homes against strong winds, storm surges, coastal flooding, and other hazards.
Sea Grant also advises coastal communities as they prepare for and respond to a changing climate. This helps communities adapt to sea level rise, coastal flooding, coastal erosion, and saltwater intrusion.
Harmful algal blooms pose a hazard to swimmers and the seafood industry on all U.S. coasts. Sea Grant programs help protect the public by informing business leaders and decision makers about the causes and effects of these hazards.
With leadership from Alaska Sea Grant, the program has worked to reduce the number of deaths in the nation's fishing industry for 45 years. It was instrumental in establishing the National Fishing Vessel Safety Act, and it has sponsored Coast Guard certified safety training that has reached thousands of tribal and commercial fishers nationwide.
Sea Grant programs across the country are active members of the National Working Waterfront Network, which helps communities enhance coastal access, balance competing uses, and plan for the future of waterfronts, waterways, and ports.
Sea Grant also works with nature-based tourism businesses, recreational fishermen, and the charter boat industry to help them become more sustainable and profitable.
Using our coastal resources wisely and sustainably depends on having healthy coastal ecosystems. In 2009 alone, Sea Grant led the restoration of nearly 32,000 acres of degraded aquatic ecosystems across the nation. This included reestablishing aquatic vegetation in Chesapeake Bay to reduce its low oxygen dead zones in summer, restoring tens of thousands of acres of degraded coastal habitat in the Gulf of Mexico, vital to sea turtles, marine mammals, and birds, and rebuilding much of the 1,400 acres of washed away wetlands and protective barrier islands in Lake Michigan's Green Bay.
Much of what we know today about nutrient runoff in coastal waters is an outgrowth of university research funded by Sea Grant over the last 50 years. Today, this knowledge is a key component of the Nonpoint Education for Municipal Officials program created by Sea Grant, which links decisions about land use and water quality. NEMO now assists decision makers in 30 states.
Increased international trade has brought another threat to our aquatic ecosystems. Perhaps the best known of these was the 1990s zebra mussel invasion of the Great Lakes. Sea Grant saved industries millions of dollars by providing rapid, highly effective responses to this and other invasions through coordinated research, outreach, and education.
Education is at the heart of the Sea Grant model. Sea Grant provides teachers with curricula and works with students from kindergarten through high school to enhance marine environmental literacy and stewardship. It also promotes the wide range of careers in these fields.
Sea Grant's John A. Knaus Marine Policy Fellowship Program trains the best and brightest graduates in marine science, conservation, and policy. It has launched the careers of many of our nation's leaders in marine, coastal, and Great Lakes-related fields. To date, the program has provided over 1,000 fellowships in Congress and federal agencies in Washington, D.C.
Annually, Sea Grant provides financial support to nearly 1,000 master's and doctoral students. Over the last 50 years, this support translates into nearly 10,000 graduates with advanced degrees, most of them working in our coastal communities.
Sea Grant has given America safer seafood,
more productive fisheries,
more resilient coastal communities,
healthier coastal ecosystems,
and stronger coastal economies.
America needs Sea Grant today more than ever
to provide the technical expertise,
scientific research,
and workforce education necessary to address the coastal, ocean, and Great Lakes issues of today
and decades to come.